There are simple annotation projects, and then there are complex ones. Today, let's focus on the latter. This video will show how to handle annotations in situations where multiple objects in an image overlap each other, thus complicating the annotation process. Here, we've created two tasks, one with images and another with a video. We've preliminarily annotated them to save time, so let's explore what we can do and how CVAT features can help us better organize shapes. We will start with the task with images. Here we have a labeled crowd with numerous overlapping rectangles, making it challenging to determine which object each rectangle belongs to. To resolve this issue, we can switch the color by option to Instance in the Appearance settings, ensuring that each rectangle instance has its own distinct color. Also, let's set the selected opacity to 50 so that the box fills halfway when hovered over. Now we can see the boundaries of the objects better, but we can also hover the mouse over each object to highlight it. One person was missed, let's annotate them. Sometimes, further editing an object may be difficult due to overlaps with others. However, you can easily locate and select this object in the side panel, then press and hold the Control key to not only highlight it but also keep it active and in focus for hassle-free editing. Let's switch to the video. We know that there are tasks when it's necessary to track an object across several frames. To simplify the task, we may want to view only one specific object and hide all others. To achieve this, you can utilize the Switch Hidden Property feature, or press H on your keyboard, to hide a single object. Alternatively, you can press the T plus H key combination or click on the eye icon in the objects panel to hide all visible objects, except for the one you've selected. Then you can keep tracking as far as you need. The downside here is that track objects not marked on the current frame may appear on the following ones. To avoid this, we can use a filter. In the filter conditions, we can specify the ID of the object we are interested in so that only this object remains visible. Now we can continue annotating this object. When you have finished annotating this object, you can now turn off the filter and move on to annotating the next object. These tips might look simple, but they will improve the accuracy and speed of annotation greatly. We promise. We encourage you to try them yourself. If there are any questions left, welcome to the comments. And that is it for today. Like, subscribe, share. Happy annotating.